All right, still heading vaguely north after we've cleared out that bandit camp. Enjoy your new way of life, everybody. Bye forever. No big deal, I just irrevocably changed your lives for the better and now I'm leaving. Is this the bridge? Yeah, okay. This'll take me where I'm trying to go over time. I figure we'll stick to roads a bit, particularly because that's where the camps tend to hide out. It leads to less of me jumping around like a lunatic, trying to make my way up walls you're not supposed to go up and making things harder for myself. There's the big rhino guy again. Yeah. Hey, my heels are actually full up. That doesn't happen too often. Ooh, check the river for fishies. Not even an fishy, huh? I mean, I guess it's going fast. So if they were there, they'd wear themselves out if they were trying to survive there long term. We're getting close to that equipment stash. It's a charger area. So those are supposed to be rams. Are they neutral? Because you're like right next to them and you seem unfazed. Why, yes, I would like free sample. How did you know? While we're on that, how am I doing on potions? Did I recraft? Vaguely okay, really? To start. 9 out of 12, it's something. I'm actually using them now. In the early game, it just felt pointless because I took only minor amounts of damage every now and then and would just tap up on the D-pad to do that heal over time. But that doesn't always suffice anymore. They're just everywhere around here. Ah! He had to turn around at that exact moment. I'm leaving now, bye. 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 Uh-oh, that's a loud noise. Where is it? They're still coming, kinda. Ooh, boy. Oh! Not overriding that, he saw me. It's fine, it's fine, it's fine. We're just gonna grab the stash. Gimme.
He said it would be.
Cool.
Not a bad selection. I'll put those to use.
Oh, a rope caster.
Because I want you to succeed. Good hunting. We'll talk later.
Wait! Damn him.
Oh, I just placed who that voice actor is. He sounded so familiar. He's the guy from Fringe. And I guess he was also in Quantum Break. Is it Quantum Break? The time travel movie with Iceman. Or time travel video game with Iceman that has live action in it for some reason. But I remember him from Fringe. I remember that actor now. I don't know his name or many of his roles, but now at least I can stop wondering who the hell he was. Just making our way through. Place lacks humans for now. We'll see how long that lasts.
All these ruins. What do the old ones do here?
What does it look like on the map? Little hard to tell from here. Kind of looks like a shopping center, honestly. A bunch of tall, square buildings. Could be a military base, or... Now I'm seeing them from this angle. Look at that exterior thing on the outside. That looks like it'd be like a... That looks like a parking structure, almost? No. I don't think that strip going around the outside served a functional purpose. I think it was just
What's
a cosmetic thing.
Oh,
crap. There's humans here now. Oh.
Just stay out of their way for now.
What's that up there?
Oh yeah, there's humans everywhere now.
Are you going to hide like a coward or come out and fight?
Oh, you come out. I don't want to. Let's see, we're weaving through these places, so I gotta go. Yeah, there's a road that goes like into the building, it looks like.
Nothing there.
Is he leaving now? There he goes. I imagine this place will look more familiar as I go in. Right now it's so destroyed and covered in snow. It's a little hard to make out. It could just be like office buildings or... I don't know what I'm looking at over there. Huh? It's rough. Someone spotting me right now? Someone went,
A corruptor. That might prove a challenge.
That's fine, I'm just gonna go over here now. Uh-oh. Just keep going. Just keep walking. Walking. Uh-oh. He super noticed me. That's bad. There goes those guys. Could you politely have things fall off of you now, please? Yep.
The eclipse and corrupted machines.
Alright. Alright. I almost made it out, but I just couldn't figure out where to continue in the moment. Is it up here? It is up here. Dang it. I would have escaped, but it was a dead end. And I'm like, ah, crap, where's the spot to continue? I guess now we're good.
An explosion.
Sounds like there's some bad news out there. I can't make sense of where we are right now. It's just a structure, it's just a building. Rectangular building, metal. So bombed out and gone that it's just the vague skeleton.
Now, always said, patience.
Tiny meat. Hey, there's another vessel for us. I like that I just blew up stuff and went crazy for a while, then just left.
Another explosion.
What are we walking in on?
Rotate turret! Operation. Time to get it moving, and be quick about it. No daydreaming.
Soon this demon will be up and running. Another Deathbringer to fill out the ranks.
Has to be one of the Deathbringers Olin talked about. Name. I'll never get into that tower. Unless I destroy that thing first.
Focus. It stopped working.
I've disabled his focus.
I'll handle this. Steam's blasting out. I wonder if those are weak points.
Crap. I'm like, I got this. And then I failed to heal. I tried pressing down on the D-pad to heal with a potion. It didn't work. Maybe I was in the middle of rolling still. I definitely realized I was low on health, but I missed my chance.
Has to be one of the Deathbringers Olin talked about.
Let's see how we can do this.
Taking fire over here.
Yep.
Thing really hurt it.
There we go. We got him. Hi guys. How you doing? Ho ho ho! They found me. So I get for prioritizing the primary objective over all else. I'm not really doing great with his shots, am I? Oh boy. There we go. Screw you guys, I've got explodies! Now you come here. You come over here. What, do you see the bombs? Ah! Do they know about my bombs? What the heck? Look at you little shits being clever. Okay. Headshot. Nailed it. Clear? Can I loot these? They show up like items. Ah! Dang it, it's so hard to see at this distance. Have you noticed that they have arcing arrows and I don't? God damn it, stand still for a second. There we go. It's interesting how my arrows, their arrows arc through the air like mortars, and mine, well, or like arrows, I guess, and mine absolutely do not. Oh, my proximities are gone now. Oh well. Yeah, my arrows shoot in perfectly straight lines in a way that defies all arrows in video games, but because our bow is essentially a gun in this game. Definitely makes it interesting when I have to shift between this game and Zelda. I'm like, oh right, my arrows have gravity in that game. respect gravity in that game, I mean. Ooh. That's a big old hair coil is what that is. So these things are defeatable, at least. I should put that in. This is why I'm happy I got my tinker skill, so I can just take these things in and out whenever I feel like it without having to worry about how I'm hurting my effectiveness or anything. Just go further into tear. Just make it absurd. Just boom, infinity tear. It's got 3 tear modifiers on it now. Still,
it's heavy.
Did that last guy leave or something? Like, what's going on? Huh. We burned through my fire supplies a bit, mostly my blazes, but other than that, we didn't really use that much of my supplies. I guess I gotta go find this one dude who's still alive, right? Ooh, a supply crate. My objective is still to kill all the dudes, but I don't know where the last dude is. I saw a question mark floating around earlier. There he is. Clear.
Did it. Those things pack a punch. All right. That Eclipse officer had a focus. Let's see what's on it. Let's see what you have to say. What? What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
What the hell was that? Hades?
Hey! Mysterious stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh?
Figures.
Well, crap.
Things just keep getting stranger. I need to find a way inside the tower.
So got a bit of a Chosen One story thing going on here where we are finding out that we are specifically important, apparently. Either us or our focus, I suppose. Something that is us is important for reasons that we don't understand. And it probably tied to the fact that they were going after that person that looked a lot like me. I'm wondering if maybe... What if she's a clone? Like, what if it's not her mother, but instead, like, she's the next incarnation of an ongoing thing or something? Whatever this thing's calling the entity. Can I climb here or something? Like, there's an item up there. But where does the game allow me to climb? Is the issue? Because if this is a different game, there's like 20 places I could climb. But in this game, it's like, nope, you gotta find the special spot that will allow you to ascend. Can't grab that. So we didn't find any new information just now necessarily, but we did just give them information in that now they're aware of our existence. And they're not happy about it. So that's a new problem I get to deal with. When it's probably the... Ooh, is this how I get across? There we go. That's probably going to be like the big next inciting incident. The first one being the proving being attacked, and this one, and then now this being that this happened just now. What is happening to the color scheme right now? It's weird. Everything's dark and dreary, and like it almost looks like my own. Yes. Yeah. The it almost looks like the colors used to denote items are changing. Ooh. Who's a big valuable corpse, if you are? Alright. Off we go. They made a point to give me a rope caster, so I guess that must have been useful against that guy, but instead I just blew him up. Explosions.
Looks tight, but I can squeeze through.
Hold for identity scan.
One of these again.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside. You are 355,510 days overdue for your meeting with Mr. Fairman. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
Wait. She said 350,000 years ago, and you said that's hundreds of years ago. That's a very different scale. That's a very different scale. Okay, how is any of this place still functioning? It is interesting how the entire place has just completely given up. Like, it has a sealed door for letting us in, but it sure as hell hasn't kept moisture out, which has deposited gargantuan deposits everywhere and made a mess of everything. This place is defunct. It would be really surreal to see an actual, like, clean room you escape into. Like, getting to some place that was still actually... together after all this time, but that'd be incredibly unlikely. Listen, geology's powerful. You will lose. It is not a fight you win. Lots of holographic displays, but not anything we can interact with yet. This is probably the go-to place we'd be likely to find another video log, which I'm looking forward to finding, because they kind of tease us with that at the beginning with the birthday thing, but... If I remember correctly, I still only have, like, one other one. Data points. Yeah, we have a lot of audio. Wait, video's the next one down, isn't it? Yeah, we have two holograms now. Yeah, the Olin message and the happy birthday, and that's it. And there's a lot of them waiting. So it's probably going to be core story developments. The ones that they didn't want to leave to just being nothing but an audio log.
Ah!
Oh, there's something.
The protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to Black Quartz standard. Your words. Look, if you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Heart's Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines. But they got out of control. Sounds bad.
I'm definitely leaning towards the idea of us being a clone. Because with the amount of time that's passed, if we were just somebody who was created naturally, through, you know, parents and all that, over this time scale, like, we'd have like a Genghis Khan style problem, right? Where, as far as genes go, basically everybody would be able to open the door because they'd all be related to Sobek, or nobody would be able to open the door because the specificity of genetic code required to be correct would never be possible, ever, basically. Unless we're gonna go like super long term, like impossible. I would hate to have it be the mathematical improbability of like, wow, all the genes recombined in the perfect way after all these generations to be just like your great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandmother again. That'd be too stupid and too contrived as far as like the probability of it goes. So something more deliberate, like a clone of some kind, makes a bit more sense, especially since we were found supposedly without parents, just from the machine. The suggestion would be that we would be like the modern reincarnation of Sobek. Despite how glowy and important these things look, there is no interaction to be done with them. Is that a clock over here? It's just spouting gibberish, though. Even their clocks were holograms. Which way was I going? Uh-oh. I went this way? Yeah, okay. That's the exact pattern I took. You probably not gonna open. You look like you're encased in rock. I don't think that's going anywhere unless we really work at it for a while. It's like tunneling a cave, except through metal. After the rock part. Look how much water has been in here and then frozen over. This whole place is just claimed. This part's not even part of the structure anymore, it's just a cave. Could just run straight to our destination, but of course I want to look around. Because this is what originally caught my attention about this game, is when we first...
A Deathbringer. Or a statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Feral leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining, fully automated technology. From revolutionary consumer products close to home, like the Feral Focus, to the dynamic chariot line of peacekeeping robots halting bloodshed in conflict zones across the globe, Feral remains committed to making the future smarter, brighter, safer, and always surprising. Feral Automated Solutions. For every problem of life, a smart solution.
So they made the Focus. 25,000 people? That's bigger than a tribe. So they made machines and devices. I guess those things were common in their world.
Reception log. Field Commandant Dang of the Indo-Malay Agricultural Combine arrived with his delegation. Refreshments to be served before 10:15 a.m., sales presentation on the chariot line. Per instructions, food will be vegetarian only. So that'd be the Indonesian and Malaysian combine? 2064, so this is still in our future. Sander Agnew, Vice President of Territorial Integrity from Fresh Grounds Coffee Global, arrived with his entourage, refreshments, blah blah blah, Tacoma blend, no artificial creamers. 10:12 a.m. So that happened. Called security and janitorial to clean up the coffee that was spilled. Actually, more like thrown. I wasn't aware that the Indo-Malay Combine grows coffee beans, and that Fresh Grounds acquisition team has tried to take their fields by force, repeatedly. I think Commandant Dang and Agnew I think Commandant Dang had Agnew by the hair for a second there. Who schedules these things? I'm gonna drop a line to sales. We can't have that happen again. That's a mess. They cross-scheduled people that are having an actual conflict with each other. Check the side room I didn't quite walk into before I went in there. So this is it. We're on our way to finding some answers, I think. This is gonna give us some context and maybe on who we are and who, and hopefully why the machines even exist and why they're like basically robot dinosaurs and stuff. Oh, they are surprisingly not robot dinosaur-y compared to what we originally thought. Like I feel like the sales pitch was practically like, it's a game where you fight robot dinosaurs, but like most of the robots are like straight up not reminiscent of dinosaurs. They're very different kinds of mech interpretations. Is it just the one box? I didn't see an audio thing around here. We'll keep pressing forward. Oh boy, this place is a mess. Can I interact with you? Oh!
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today.
Yeah, it's the same audio from earlier. I think it is. Thought it was gonna be might be something new because I had the activation option. Thankfully, it turns off when you walk away. Cause dang, that recording is loud, like louder than anything else in the game. It seems like it might just be the tinniness of it that makes it abrasive to listen to.
What were they doing here?
How did we just get our We just got a bio for Elizabeth Sobeck. Elizabeth Sobeck, born March 11th, 2020, is an American scientist, roboticist, and engineer, widely regarded as one of the greatest minds of the 21st century. Born and raised outside Carson City, Nevada, she enrolled in Stanford University at age 13, earning a Bachelor of Science in Experimental Physics and Computer Science at age 16. She completed her PhD in Robotics and Artificial Intelligence Design at Carnegie Mellon University in 2040, and joined Faro Automated Solutions as a junior scientist the same year. Rising quickly to chief scientist at the age of 22, over the next 8 years, her green robot designs played a vital role in realizing the environmental cleanup and detoxification efforts of the clawback decade, propelling FAS to the forefront of its field. In 2048, she suddenly resigned from FAS, protesting the company's pivot to automated military technologies. In 2049, she founded Miriam Technologies, a firm devoted to life-positive robotics and other technologies. Miriam has since become one of the world's largest suppliers of green robots, winning numerous awards and accolades, including the 2053 Nobel Prize for Physics and the 2056 Rachel Carson Award for Environmental Progress. So in case it wasn't clear, we're of course praising green as in like environmentally friendly, as opposed to like green robots, like, whoa, we painted our robots green! We get awards for it now. So what happened is she was a very talented roboticist, so she's basically, what we're finding out is that we're like the reincarnation, probably maybe, of the person who made this entire world we live in right now with the machines and set this all in motion. But she had very different ideals. Maybe, like, the fact that they're weird, like, nature robots kind of fits here, because she was trying to make something that would integrate into life and would have, like, hopefully not have a footprint as far as, like, you know, carbon footprint and pollution and various other things. I try to create things like that. That's why we have these ones that clearly scavenge other robots, and we recycle everything and reuse everything. Like, that kind of stuff seems to be part of what she was going after. But then people were like, let's turn this into machine weapons, which I guess she really should have seen that coming, to be honest. It's not to discount anything, because damn, it sucks that happens, but yeah, if you're gonna make mechs, guess what everyone's gonna try to do with your mechs? They're gonna blow shit up.